So I've knocked together a wiring diagram similar to what we had in the installation. So here I'm replicating the two gang switch. It was a dimmer, but it's a two gang switch. We had a set of lights and a set of lights independently switched from there. And we had the feed coming into the actual switch and then obviously going switch line, neutral and CPC out, switch line, neutral and CPC going out. I've used old cable colors because the video also had old cable colors in it. So line is red, neutral is black, and our green and yellow conductor is our CPC. So that's our wiring diagram. Now there were some differences between maybe doing the safe isolation procedure in a controlled college environment and how I did it in the installation. So if we bring in the consumer unit, I've got one here. So obviously it's very similar to the one we had into the installation. We had everything on in the installation bar one circuit. The breaker was in a slightly different position, but we had a B6 amp circuit breaker for the downstairs light turned off and locked off. And this is a single pole device. So when I turn it off, it breaks that line conductor. And then we locked it off. Everything else was on, including the main switch. So the main switch was left on where we had the line and neutral tails coming out of it. Okay, so we had the line and neutral tails and it was left on. We also had the earthing conductor coming out of our earth bar going off as well. So that was our supply coming in, was left connected and on during that testing process. So what I've done on the drawing, down here, I've made this bottom section closed. On all my other wiring diagrams, this is open. That's effectively showing the double pole switch with our live conductors, our tails, our neutral and line tail. So that is closed, but we knew the breaker was off. So this breaker here is actually single pole and turned off. When we were doing our testing for voltage, we kept getting that continuity beep, didn't we? So whenever I touched between my neutral and protective conductor, I got a beep, didn't get any voltage, but I got a continuity beep. Now, hopefully we can realize why when we test between our neutral and our CPC, our switch, that actually we got a continuity beep when we think about where this cable goes through the installation to our consumer unit and then from our tails down. The installation we were at had a TNS earthing arrangement. Terra, neutral are separate. So you're thinking, well, they can't be connected together. They're separate in the installation, the neutral and CPC, and they're meant to be separate on the supply authority's side. But it takes us back to that learning on earthing arrangement. So if I bring this picture in next, this is our one for our TNS earthing arrangement. Okay, so this is our installation here and our circuit, and we can see we've got a separate neutral and a separate protective conductor throughout. And it goes back to the metering equipment, and then it goes back along the road. This bit here is the bit in the road. I know it's hard to imagine it. And that goes all the way back to the supply transformer. And look what happens at the supply transformer. The neutral and protective conductor are connected together. They are connected just there. Nothing in the installation, nothing at the metering equipment on a TNS earthing arrangement, actually at the supply transformer. So if we come back to this drawing, what we could do then is we could show that these are linked together. So these were linked together. They're linked together actually at the supply transformer. Okay, so they are connected together. That's not something that we can see, physically see, that would be at the transformer end. But by connecting them together, hopefully now we can see when we come in and probe on to our CPC and our neutral, we've actually got a closed loop. So in other words, a closed loop giving us that continuity beep. No voltages, but a closed loop. So if I plot that round, we've actually got a path from the CPC back to here, through our earthing conductor, all the way back to the supply transformer, and then coming back along the neutral. So that's why you get a continuity beep when you're testing between the protective conductor and the neutral. Now, it also could have been a TNCS earthing arrangement, and that's probably one that you think, well, I understand that they're connected together. So it wasn't a TNS earthing arrangement. Let's imagine it was a TNCS earthing arrangement, and we know that the earth and neutral, okay, are connected together. The earthing conductor is connected to the neutral at the cutout, so at the supply head. And we've seen that many times on the channel as well. And we know the neutral throughout its run is PME'd, protective multiple earthing through a pen conductor, protective earth neutral. And this is the PME earth electrodes here. So we've got our neutral connected to earth, our neutral connected to earth. So in both instances, the TNS and the TNCS, at some point, the earthing conductor is connected to the neutral. Hence, when we do our voltage measurement between our neutral and our protective conductor in the installation, we get no volts, it was isolated supply, but we had a continuity buzz because they are connected together elsewhere in the installation, and we're talking about maybe beyond the installation in a TNS earthing arrangement. So that's why that one beeped. I've wiped it clean, we're gone again. We also got a continuity beep when we were testing between the neutral and the switching line connection within the switch. So between there and there, we got a beep, and between our neutral and our switching line, we also got a beep. In other words, we got that continuity buzz, didn't we? And now we're between, hang on a second, Gaz, we're between neutral and switching line conductors. And how can they be connected together? Well, our neutral comes up to here, and our switching line conductor comes up to here, and we can clearly see at the light fitting, those two cables are not connected together. So how did they beep? Well, let's think about what we actually had in our installation. We had all our lamps in circuit. Our lamps are connected across our switching line and neutral connections. So let's bring those in. So we bring in a little bit of flex, say, that comes out to our lamp. So let's bring out the neutral one as well. And let's make that nice and clear. Let's make that element there. Okay, between those. So we actually had the lamps in circuit. The lamp is connected across the neutral and switching line. Okay, we left those in circuit. Something we don't do at college, is it? We don't have lamps in circuit when we're doing this style of testing. So when we're back down here, again at our switch, when we're testing between our neutral and our switching line, we've actually got the connection via the lamp to come back round and therefore give us that continuity buzz. So let's plot that round as well. So it will come from our neutral. We're getting a connection. We're going to get a connection that goes through the lamp and actually connects to our switching line conductor. And therefore, that's why it's beeping. It's not got any voltage. It was isolated, wasn't it? When we probed on in that previous video, we saw that we had no volts between the neutral and switching line, but we certainly got a little beep or a buzz. Our lamp was in circuit, completing the connection between the switching line and neutral connection. If I bring an old tungsten filament lamp in here, it's probably easier for you to see. We've got the two stalks there connected to, it doesn't matter which way around they are, neutral and switching line. We know that has no polarities. It's a bayonet cap lamp. We've mentioned that many times on the channel. But that filament wire is connected across the two points. So that filament wire being here, connected across our two points, therefore connecting together our switching line and neutral. And we can prove that by just going onto the back of the lamp holder. If I probe onto here and here, let's get them in the right place. Okay, we can see we've got a beep. By connecting onto those two, we've got a continuity or a loop through the actual filament wire. Hence, when we're testing between neutral and switching line, again, we had no voltage, but we had a continuity beep. And then finally, we also had a continuity beep between our circuit protective conductor and our switching line. So when we were on those two in our video, we also got a beep. No voltage was present, but we got that continuity beep. So this is now going to be a combination of what we've just looked at in learning in order to work out why this one has a complete loop. So let's put our lamp back in circuit. So we know we've got a lamp now. So if we bring our lamp in, take my two little strands up, and we connect the lamp. We know that was in circuit. So we bring that in. Okay, but we were testing between switching line and CPC. We also got to remember that we had our earthing arrangement, even though it was a TNS, our neutral and earth were connected maybe back at that supply transformer. So let's connect those two together and now work out if we've got a path between our CPC and our switching line conductor. So if we come up our switching line conductor here, we can go up here and round. We find that then that is actually going to come through the lamp and go through there and then down our neutral. Ah, so that's gone through the neutral as a path. And where's our neutral going to end up? It comes all the way down to the connector. It comes back, goes back to the consumer unit, goes through the double pole switch, which is actually closed, isn't it, within the consumer unit. And we know eventually that neutral will be connected to the CPC. So we're now back on the CPC's run, and that comes back to our earth terminal. So we can now see that when we probe between our switching line conductor and our CPC, it was the fact that the lamp was connected that meant the switching line connection passed through the lamp and got onto the neutral. The neutral comes all the way through the system and at some point is connected to the protective conductor in a TNS and a TNCS earthing arrangement and back round. Hence, when we probe between those, we got that continuity beep. So that's why we did. No voltage, it was fully isolated, but some people get confused when they hear that beeping noise, when they're doing the safe isolation, they're thinking, is that a voltage present? The machine will read the voltage present. The beep itself is a continuity, in other words, a complete loop, of which we've proved in three different ways there. So you might be out in the real world and think to yourself, oh, I've just done the safe isolation procedure. I've turned off my device and I've gone out and I haven't got that beep that Gary's been talking about. It might be a number of reasons, but it might be that you haven't got just an MCB in circuit. Obviously this one is protected by an RCD where there wasn't one in the installation that we had. It was just separate from it. So a slightly different arrangement of the consumer, but we were interested in the main switch. You might find you've actually got an RCBO. So an RCBO will have a neutral and line connection in it. And when you break it, you might be thinking, ah, that might not just break the line conductor, but actually break the neutral as well. Now that could be the case. You have to look at your devices really carefully and the pictures on them, and that will explain whether you have a switched neutral. This one doesn't. So even by operating this RCBO and locking it off, you've actually got a solid neutral link connection all the way back. So you would still get that continuity beep if your installation that we've just seen in the safe isolation video had RCBOs in. We'd have still got that beep because it hasn't got a break in the neutral when you operate that device. Lots of manufacturers are moving over now to a switched neutral RCBO. And again, it's a case of having to look on the side to see if you've got a switched neutral. It's difficult on this one to see. We'll perhaps make a separate video about it. And then what you'll do is when you've obviously isolated the circuit and locked it off, you sometimes therefore disconnect both the line and neutral. And by breaking those, we obviously break the neutral here as well as the line here at the overcurrent protection device. By breaking them both, you can see how we've effectively removed the link, which will be further downstream on a TNS and a TNCS earthing arrangement that gives us that loop back. So you might be out there and think to yourself, oh, I've just done safe isolation procedure. It didn't beep like Gary said it would. It's a combination of understanding what's happening in circuit to understand whether you have a complete loop or not.